Hey neighbor, welcome back to ARTV. My name is John and it's time for a review of the 12th, wait, is that right? The 12th studio album, that's a little bit hard to believe, by the indie rock band Car Seat Headrest. It's called Making a Door Less Open, and it's a pretty significant departure from the lo-fi and DIY Car Seat Headrest of yesteryear. Just for clarity's sake, there are multiple versions of this album's track listing for the vinyl, for the CD, and the digital edition. I'm reviewing the digital edition because that's the most widely available. Car Seat Headrest really exploded onto the indie scene with the release of Teens of Denial in 2016. This followed up their successful in the indie sphere Teens of Style and many other lo-fi albums, most of which are not really my style, but I can appreciate the fact that they do have a lot of traits, a lot of good qualities to them. I hopped on board with Teens of Style and Teens of Denial, and of course that fantastic twin fantasy face-to-face remake of one of their earlier records. It's a full band now, it started off as just Will Toledo, and now this record, Making a Door Less Open, we have something that's feeling a bit more electronic, a little bit more rock, a little bit more this, and a little bit more that. It's all about stirring in all of the spices, and as a result of that, we get an album that feels less like an album and more like a mixtape. That doesn't automatically have to be a negative. I've heard some really enjoyable, or at the very least catchy, albums that felt more like a collection of singles than they did a full-fledged record, but the problems that go against Making a Door Less Open have more to do with feeling undercooked or just raw in places. Like, I know they can do a whole lot better. To be fair, Will Toledo himself has spoken about this. He's aware of the fact that it feels less like an album and more like a collection of tracks, at least in places. It is meant to be consumed as a whole, but also he's trying to give in to the playlist placement thing where Apple Music and Spotify and Tidal, they take individual songs and then they put it here, they put it there. And yeah, this album definitely has elements of EDM, of hip-hop, of soul, of doo-wop, of indie, of rock, and back again. Where do you even begin when talking about the sound of this album? Because it truly does touch on all of those genres I just listed a minute ago. Will Toledo and fellow band member of Car Seat Headrest Andrew Katz have a side project called One Trait Danger, and I wasn't really familiar with their works, but after checking them out for the sake of this review just for context, this definitely feels, at least in places, more like a One Trait Danger album. Like, were they contractually obligated to release something under the Car Seat Headrest name this year, or...? In my experience, the best way to take on this album is just to go in with the thought of, okay, maybe each song is not gonna work for me as a whole. At least there's going to be some good songs, maybe some that I don't vibe with, but there's probably going to be something there for me. Even with keeping an open mind, it still is a struggle to comprehend what's going on behind the scenes, because it feels messy, it feels like the production is off in places. It can work really well, it can work to their advantage, like on the opening track Weightlifters, which apparently kicked off this entire thing. It sparked the revolution in Will Toledo's mind, like, hey, let's do a little bit more of an electronic thing. The ideas date back to 2015, and we're just now getting them in 2020, and with that much time on their hands, it feels like it could have turned out a bit better. Since I already mentioned it by name, let's go ahead and talk about the catalyst, the opening track, Weightlifters. This is one that features some jaunty little guitar riffs, some fast ones that really work their way in. I feel that they do it a great service, but also the synth tone, the way that it feels that it's kind of always creeping up and ascending throughout the entire track, it really works for me. I also like the stream of consciousness styled lyrics that Will Toledo just kind of touts out there. It's something that feels like it's bleeding from the back of his mind, but he has to get it out, and it makes it feel a lot more urgent and important. Both of the Deadlines tracks, both Deadlines Hostile and Deadlines Thoughtful, really work for me, but in vastly different ways. We have the more rock-centric Hostile that definitely feels aggressive, pensive. I love the mood swing that this song brings, but also on the other Deadlines, we have Thoughtful, which is definitely a more electronic in nature, one that feels like it's building up towards an EDM-style drop, and even though it is so wonky, there's so much going on in the mix, I feel like I'm about to head to a rave, and it really works, even though this is a very, very different Car Seat Headrest, no longer DIY, no longer so indie or so stripped back. This is something that feels like it could just hit you over the head and you don't even have to be mad about it. Can't Cool Me Down was released as the lead single, and immediately I felt knotted up about this tune, because still, even 20 listens later, I feel this is something that I have mixed feelings on. I love the bass groove. I love the fact that it does feel very collaborative. I feel some sort of chemical energy from the band and the way that they intertwine with each other. And I do appreciate the chorus, but at the same time, there's other parts that just kind of irk me in terms of production or even in terms of synth tones. It just kind of doesn't quite get the job done, at least not all the way. Even though there's other tracks that I really do appreciate, namely towards the end of this record, Life Worth Missing and There Must Be More Than Blood, the latter of those feeling very dreamy, very atmospheric, mainly because it was based on a dream that Will had. There's also other songs that really kind of anger me to a degree. Like, how exactly did this come to fruition? Now, I really do like what Will said about this album. He said he wrote these songs and it feels like they could be played in a variety of different styles, genres, and settings. And that's exactly what he did for him. But unfortunately for us, on the digital edition, we get the Him remix. And having heard the vinyl edition that has the original recording that feels a little bit more Radiohead influenced, this just feels like a lot of repetition, a lot of nonsense that just floats itself out there and it feels abrasive for no reason. I also really don't like the way that this album closes out on the track Famous. It's meant to raise more questions than it does give answers, but it just feels frustrating. It feels like this omnipresent idea of repetition, of monotonous behavior, and it finally finishes and you're like, okay, I crossed the finish line, but what now? Really though, I'm just white-knuckling and buying time before I get to the track that I detest the most on this entire record. It's one that doesn't feel authentic really in any way to the band. It feels very lazy. It feels like they passed it off and just put it out there because, oh, this might get some airplay or this might get placed in a rock playlist, and what do you know, it's already their most successful song in terms of charting in the United States. It's Hollywood. It sees Will Toledo and Andrew Katz railing against the man without saying anything at all. How dare you play a trick like this on us, good sirs? This is something that feels like it has punk energy and tenacity, but it feels like the elastic just bounces right back and snaps you in the face like a bad rubber band. If you're gonna actually wade into these waters, then go for it. Don't stand around and say, I don't wanna get in, there might be sharks out there, so I really won't do anything other than put a toe in, because that's exactly what Hollywood feels like. Despite there being some outstanding cuts on the LP, like the Beck-influenced Martin that really does scratch an itch for me in the Deadlines tracks and Weightlifters, I don't feel that there's enough to really merit an entire album. It just feels like maybe it could have been boiled down to an EP because the other tracks are totally dragging it back down into the mire. Overall for me, Car Seat Headrest, Making a Door Less Open, I'm feeling a 3 out of 5. And I would love to know what you guys think, because this is definitely a confusing, but also divisive album. Thanks for tuning into my Car Seat Headrest review. If you enjoyed what you saw, despite if you didn't agree entirely or not, please hit that like button, because a like truly does go a long way to help support the channel. Subscribe and ring the bell so you actually get notified when I upload. If you want to see another Car Seat Headrest review, then tap this card here, or tap here for the Quarter One Album Awards Roundup Show. Other than that, all of my socials, including my Patreon, can be found in the links down below, and I'll see you soon for more on ARTV.